Dhammataya tanto dhammante no adranaya sa Nibuddho nibbanataya tan lokatranami Lokatrano lokatumma ipozaya tasupchito mudo Yo nago buddha naga miro yadhyā sindhi yato tachinya swapyādi Buddho tisalin kuro rāin to tventi miyano muvi pshayue Bodhāya sa chatai tātu bhubodhu rokutu tenlen tijā bhāze jencho ngā lagao Tanto kuroga bhiyin chido mui pshayue Dhammataya sa chatai tatu bhubhulu rokutu mayin yin chicha si ching alagao Tanto kuranga bhiyinkili tau pukhate yin do mui pshayue Dhammataya sa chatai tatu bhubhulu rokutu mayin kili tapu ninja bhase ching alagao Dino vatandeya nevangare chango Bhuta chau chau kuro rai yau ki
Thank you. ဒါကြာရအကုန်ကောင်းကြံတာကြာကုန်ပြီပြည့်ဝဘုဒ္ဓသာသနာဘုဒ္ဓမြတ်စွာသံဃာတော်များကျွေးတဲ့ဝိရုမမညာပုညာနိဗ္ဗာန်ရည်ရှိကြကုန်ပြီပြည့်ဝဒုက္ခိတာကိုစင်ကြံပြန်ဤသံဃာချင်းတို့ရည်ရှိကြကုန်ပြီပြည့်ဝသဗ္ဗိဟိမိမေပါပဲသုတ်တဲ့လုံးခန္တိကိုယ်တော်လုံးသောဘုဒ္ဓညာကြီးပြည့်စုံသောဘုဒ္ဓနေသာသူတို့ဘုရား အရောကအရောကဒုက္ခကိဝေကြကုန်သည်ဒုက္ခိတာကိုစင်ကြံပြန်ဤချမ်းသာခြင်းရှိကြကုန်သည်ဘောဓာဖြစ်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်းသဗ္ဗမင်္ဂလံကိုစင်ချမ်းသာခြင်းအကြောင်းကောင်းမြတ်သောခန္တီဥသောလုံးသောမင်္ဂလာပေါင်းသည်ဘောဓာဖြစ်ပါစေသတည်းသဗ္ဗဒီဝိတ္တခန္တီကိုယ်ကံတဏ္ဍာကောနအပေါင်းတို့သည်ရက္ခဏတို့အမြဲတမ်းဆောင်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်း ဘုရားဘုရားနိဗ္ဗာန်ဝိနေကိဂဝါလူသစ္စမကပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တော်မူကြသည်ဘုသောသတိဥသောလုံးသောဘုသောဘုရားရှင်တို့၏ဘုရားတိသောအနုဘောကြောင့်သဗ္ဗဘုဒ္ဓနိဗ္ဗာန်ဝိနေခန္တေဥသောလုံးသောဘုသောဘုရားရှင်တို့၏ဘုံတော်ကိုအာယုကြည်၍ညွှန်ရသောကုသကံစိနာဤဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်သဗ္ဗဓမ္မနိဗ္ဗာန်ဝိနေမေဖို့နိဗ္ဗာန်သမေကဟုခေါ်စွာသောကတိဥသောလုံးသောဘုသောဘုရားတော်မြတ်၏ဘုဒ္ဓတော်အနု
ဘာသာကံကံမောင်ဝိနကံဒေါသလုံးသောအရာသံဃာရောမြတ်ကြီးဘုရားတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်ဘာသာကံကံမောင်ဝိနကံဒေါသလုံးသောအရာသံဃာရောမြတ်ကြီးဘုရားတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်ဘာသာကံကံမောင်ဝိနကံဒေါသလုံးသောအရာသံဃာရောမြတ်ကြီးဘုရားတော်အနုဘောကြောင့်ဤပရိနိယောသစ္စာဤသာယုတ္တိသာတေနယုလျာရှိကြဘုသောသေတ္တပရိသာပေါင်းသောကောင်းတို့သည် Thank you. พูดจังหวะนะครับอันนี้ที่ว่าทางบ่อนี้ก็เลยจะนับเป็นยอดของไทยผู้ว่าสามีก็เลยที่จะกลับกับผู้ว่าสามีเช็คที่มาสลับมาคุยยอดทางบ่อนี้
ยาดีนังเกลาบัดากันลังนังก็ดมานาวิธีกันบาวาริยา
Yeah.
out. Is there any bhikkhu who is poor in the room? For the second time, if there any bhikkhu who is poor in the room? For the third time, is there any bhikkhu who is poor in the room?
To the on the request of the donors from China and Singapore, all of us are actually very fortunate to gather in the Dharma here and listen to the Dharma preached by Bhante Buddhananda in the form of question and answer.
We don't talk much about insight meditation.
We
But we don't really know what are the objects of insight meditation. The objects of insight meditation are the first noble truth, ultimate insanity and materiality, and the second noble truth, causes and their effects. So without having realized the first noble truth and the second noble truth, impossible to practice insight meditation. So we here teach first anapana to all the beginners, and then 10 kasiya and 8 attainments. And then we teach not yet supernatural power, but to know and see ultimate mentality and activity, which are the first noble truth. But I will not teach any tradition, but I will teach the way the Buddha taught. To make all of you understand clearly, let me explain a little bit more. Buddha taught three trainings, the training of morality, the training of concentration, and the training of insight. You know what is the training of morality? For about the training of concentration, you need to know that Buddha taught 40 kinds of meditation objects, and among 40, 30 leads to absorption, and the rest helps to excess concentration. For about the serenity practitioners, they must first develop absorption concentration. After that, they need to continue the training of insight. When the Buddha taught about training, how many meditation objects the Buddha taught? Materiality meditation, mentality meditation. Okay? When the Buddha taught rupa meditation, Buddha taught 4 elements meditation and 3 or detaining methods. So, after having developed absorption, concentration, the serenity practitioners need to continue 4 elements meditation to know and see the ultimate materiality. So when they practice 4 elements meditation after having developed anapana pachana, finally they can break their body down into very tiny small particles. They need to analyze ultimate materiality exists in each particle. After that, they need to continue ultimate. They need to continue mentality meditation to know and see ultimate mentality. Then we continue teaching meditators to know and see causes and effects. At that time, they are ready to proceed inside meditation. Okay, This is not a tradition. This is the way taught by the Buddha. That's why those who could practice, they appreciate very much, oh, now we are practicing what the Bodhisattva had practiced, what the Buddha had practiced, what many of his disciples had practiced, not power methods. If you emulate the way the Bodhisattva practiced for his enlightenment, it is also possible for you to practice here. I will teach you that.
Yeah. explain about dependent origination.
오늘은 연기에 대해서 말씀을 드리겠습니다.
Only when the river and the was practicing in and then when the forest together with our Lord Buddha. While discerning four ways in this way, dependent origination patterns are very clear to his mind. He approached to the Buddha in the evening. Then he informed to the Buddha, Pandey, dependent origination is actually very deep and profound. However, it is very clear to my mind. In this way, he informed to the Buddha. At the dying Buddha says to the Venerable Ananda, you should not tell like that, you should not tell like that. It does not Dhammasa Ananda Buddha Abdi Veda. Iwa Maya Bhaja Tanda Kula Gaja Da Kula Gani Gaja Da Bhoja Pabhaja Buddha. Abhaya Dhaka Devuni Pada Sansara Nadi Buddha. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
지금 빨리 어려워 계속 하셨는데 이해하셨어요?
Maybe I recite this sutra because this is not my original speech. This is original speech is Buddha's teaching. I want to explain in this way. What is the meaning? Ananda, because of not understanding by direct knowledge this dependent origination, and because of not penetrating by different stages of direct knowledge this dependent origination, all these beings are not escaped from the round of rebirth. They cannot escape from the whirlpool stage. Couldn't this sutta, especially Visuddhimagga and the Sammoha Vinodini commentary, explains Pavachaka Mabdaledava Asani Uchaka Miva Nichak Nimatana Sansara Bhaya Madhido Nagochi Supi Nandari Pyachi. What is the meaning? So the meaning is Samadhi is like a stone. Upon this stone, you must sharpen your wisdom light.
Wisdom?
Light.
What is the meaning? Concentrated mind is the primary cause of wisdom faculty. If there is no concentration, wisdom faculty cannot work in this fashion. For example, now please pay attention to your body. Can you see Galapagos?
자, 예를 들면 여러분 몸에 주목을 해 보십시오. 갈라파고스를 볼 수 있나요?
Can you see?
보여요?
No, because you have no concentration. But concentrated mind can see these Galapagos as well as can analyze those Galapagos and can see adimate materiality. As well as adimate mentality and as well as their causes, that is dependent origination. What are kalpas? Maybe they translate very closely subatomic particles. These kalpas are not adimate materiality. This is the smallest group of materiality. As long as you see space, then you can see kalpas. You must practice four elements meditation if you want to see this space element. What are four elements? Earth element, water element, fire element, and wind element. If you practice four elements meditation systematically, when your concentration deep becomes deep enough, you can see transparent body like ice block because you cannot see space element. If you do not see space element, you cannot break down the compactness. If you cannot break down the competitiveness, you cannot see Kalapa. At that day, Buddha teach to see space. That concentrated mind on the four elements object also produces strong, powerful light. That light is called the light of wisdom. With the assistance of the light of wisdom, if you penetrate to see space element, at that day, you can see space. As soon as you see space, then you can see Kalapas. If you see four elements in each Kalapa, this is the last stage of Samatha. Last stage of Samatha as well as the beginning stage of Vipassana. Because of this reason, this four elements meditation is both sides, Samatha and Vipassana. If you get these four elements in each Padika, each Kalapa, then you should continue to discern color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, electrical quality, transparency, etc. You can easily discern these derivative materialities. Buddha dish, agasa, dhatu, space element. For clear understanding of these derivative materialities, in some Kalapas, there are 10 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive essence, light faculty, and eye transparency. In the same way, you should understand ear transparency, nose transparency, tongue transparency, and body transparency. Why they are called transparency? Yakadi incha vidhan rupa dina gahana bhavena rupa dina gahana vichya bhavena adasa talam viya vipassanata pasada rupa. This is the definition given in Visuddhimagga about the purification. I will explain the meaning. They are quite transparent rupas, materialities. So if there is no eye transparency, eye consciousness cannot arise. If eye consciousness cannot arise, then one cannot see color. In the same way, other transparencies are also you should understand in the same way. If there is body transparency, body consciousness arises depending on body transparency. Body consciousness can feel tangible object. In some Kalapas, there are in the same way, 10 types of materiality, but they are not transparent. They are opaque Kalapas. There are two important materialities, self-determining materiality and heart base. Heart base is mind base for mind consciousness. That heart base arises depending on inside your heart. There is blood. Depending on that blood, this heart base arises. So altogether, there are different types of derivative materialities. If you can analyze these Kalapas in this way, other than only you can understand ultimate materiality. But nowadays, there are many scientists, they do not understand about these Kalapas completely. What is the reason? In their laboratory, they can test only temperature bomb materiality. According to Buddha's teaching, this group, if we divide these rupas, there are four groups. Number one is karma bomb materiality. Number two is mind bomb materiality. Number three is temperature bomb materiality. Number four is nutriment bomb materiality. Karma is connected with previous karma, not present karma. Present karma is if there is any future existence. This is the cause for future material, future five aggregates only. So, to understand this is karma bomb materiality, we must try to discern five past causes. But these five past causes I will explain later. Every consciousness. which has to be the Mukhat paste, can produce mind bone materiality. So without understanding heart paste, without understanding mind consciousness, which has to be the Mukhat paste, you cannot discern mind bone materiality. Here, please try to see. Oh, penny, sage, which produce this penny, which produce this sage? Your mind, that mind is rest penny on your heart place. That mind produce uncountable mind bone kalapas. These kalapas spread throughout the body. Up to this end, they also spread. So, if you analyze these kalapas, in each kalapa there are 8 types of materiality. Among these 8, there is wind element. That wind element again produces bodily animation. Because of this bodily animation, new kalapas always rising and passing away. The new kalapas, they cannot rise same place, in the same place. They rise in different place. That different place rising is, you may see this is Bene Sraje. But if you see kalapas, you cannot see this Penga. You can see only kalapas. These kalapas, there are 8 types. Among 8 types, there is bodily animation. That bodily, because of this bodily animation, the whole, all rupas, they do not rise same place. If you do not see this process, then we can say you do not understand mind-bone materiality. Here is also another consciousness. Here, I-consciousness. That I-consciousness cannot produce mind-bone materiality. In the same way, ear-consciousness also cannot produce ear-bone, cannot produce mind-bone materiality. Nose consciousness also cannot produce mind-bone materiality. Tongue consciousness also cannot produce mind-bone materiality. Body consciousness also cannot produce mind-bone materiality. In the same way, you are brave. I want to tell about this. If you can discern 4 elements in your brain, you can see brain is nothing but a group of kalapas. Among those kalapas, one kalapa is body dirty kalapa. In that body dirty kalapa, there is body transparency. Depending on body transparency, body consciousness can arise. Body consciousness knows only tangible object. That body consciousness also cannot produce mind-bone materiality. Depending on that body transparency in your brain, there are 8 types of mentality, including body consciousness. Among, I will calculate this thing because I have something to tell about this problem. Number 1, consciousness. Number 2, contact. Number 3, feeling. This is neutral feeling. Then number 4 is perception.
Yes.
Number 5 is volition. Yes. Number 6 is one-pointedness. Number 7 is light faculty. Number 8 is attention. So all together, 8 types of mentalities only. Among these 8 types, there is no wisdom faculty. Wisdom faculty is dependent on your heart base only, according to Buddha's teaching. But you can discern practically. So now we have explained karma bone materiality. Number 2, mind bone materiality. And now, number 3, temperature bone materiality. What is temperature? In your eye, there is eye integrity kalapa together with eye transparency. If you analyze, there are 10 types of materiality. Among 10 types, there is fire element. That fire element can produce 4 or 5 generation new clappers. This is temperature bomb materiality. In the same way, in your mind bomb clapper, there, if you analyze your mind bomb clapper, there are, in each clapper, there are 8 types of materiality. But this mind power is very different. Ordinary mind, such as now you are listening, or I'm talking, such type of mind, listening mind, that fire element can produce 2 or 3 generations only. However, if your mind is like jhana mind or vipassana mind, that mind has strong power. That mind can produce uncountable millions of kalpas. Now many meditators, they can see light here, etc. What is that light? This is the light of wisdom. So how this arrives? You are discerning your breath, or you are concentrating on your breath object, or you are concentrating on your nimitta, anapana nimitta. If you can concentrate well, and if your concentration also becomes deeper and deeper, and then that concentrated mind associates with wisdom faculty. That wisdom deeper, when this wisdom faculty's power is very strong and powerful, then that mind can produce jhana mind, especially jhana mind, can produce strong powerful lights, not only internally but also externally. These colors spread throughout the body. Among those, if one analyzes those colors, in each color there are 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types, there is color. That color begins luminous and bright. Again, if you analyze those colors, in each color there are 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types, there is fire element. That fire element is called temperature. That temperature also produces uncountable many, many millions of kalpas. Again, if you analyze these kalpas, in each kalpa there are also in the same way 8 types of materiality. Among 8 types there is color. That color also luminous and bright. This temperature boom light, not only internally but also up to externally spread. So, internal light is both, two types is mind bong kalapas kala as well as temperature bong kalapas kala, 2 types of kalapas kala, but externally there is only temperature bong kalapas kala only. Depending on concentration, wisdom faculty's power is very strong. When concentration is very deep, wisdom faculty power also very great. When wisdom, the power of wisdom faculty is very great, then the light of wisdom is very bright. So, scientists, they do not understand this process of mind bomb materiality as well as temperature bomb materiality. Karma bomb materiality has only internally, not externally. Mind bomb materiality also arises only internally, not externally. Why they do not arise in external in any way? Well, as soon as they arise, these clappers, mind bomb materiality as well as karma bomb materiality, as soon as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. There is no time to carry from this body to laboratory. Their lifespan is only 70 mind moment only.
70.
Very short. Their lifespan is very short. So they cannot carry up to laboratory. Now every day we are eating. Food is inside our stomach. If a meditator can discern four elements and that newly eaten food, undigested food, they can see food as nothing but a group of klapas. Throughout our body there are life-knowing klapas. Among those life-knowing klapas, there is fire element. That fire element is called digestive fire. When the digestive fire supports this nutritive essence of newly eaten food, that nutritive essence can produce new generation, new klapas. In laboratory, there is no digestive fire. So because of this reason, they do not understand this nutritive as co-materiality. They can carry only one piece of flesh to the laboratory. If one meditator can discern this piece, which they carry to laboratory, this piece is a group of klapas. If one analyzes these klapas, in each klapa there are eight types of materiality. What is the source? In each klapa there is fire element. That fire element can produce new generation, new klapa. In that new generation there is also again fire element. That fire element again produces another new generation. They can test in their own laboratory this temperature of materiality only. They cannot understand, especially in each klapa there are eight types of materiality, because their investigation is in different way. My meaning is we Buddhists are very lucky.
우리 불자들은 아주 운이 좋습니다.
We can, if we practice systematically, we can understand four types of materiality by your own direct knowledge. This is the materiality aggregate only. This is the object of vipassana. If you do not understand this materiality by your direct knowledge, if you practice vipassana, your vipassana is just superficial only.
ုတ်ထဲမှာပေါ့ဩဇာထဲမှာအမြင်နဲ့ဥဒုနဲ့ဩဇာအမြင်နဲ့ပါတယ်ဒါပေမဲ့တပီတော့ဥဒုကိုသိသိပြည့်တဲ့အတွက်ဩဇာကိုလည်းဆက်နေရှောက်
So number one, you should try to understand the noble truth of suffering. What is noble truth of suffering? Sankhitena vichupadana khanda dukkha. This is in the first sermon, Dhamma Chekha Bodhana Sutta, the Dhamma Wheel Turning in Motion Sutta, Bodhana Display. In brief, five clinging aggregates are the noble truth of suffering. So, what are five clinging aggregates? The clinging aggregate of materiality, the clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. All together, there are five clinging aggregates. Among these five clinging aggregates, the clinging aggregate of materiality is materiality, rupa. The clinging aggregate of feeling, the clinging aggregate of perception, the clinging aggregate of formations, and the clinging aggregate of consciousness. These four aggregates are mentality, nama. Five clinging aggregates in nama rupa, mentality and materiality are same meaning. So if you want to become noble one, like Sotapanna, Satrivana, etc., first you must try to understand the noble truth of suffering. This is five clinging aggregates of mentality and materiality by your direct knowledge. The among five aggregates I had explained materiality aggregate in my previous Dhamma talk. Then you must continue to listen ultimate mentality. From some meditators who had already practiced jhana practice, they can easily listen this mentality. In one mind moment, for example, like I consciousness mind moment, there are eight types of mental formations. In some mind moments, like jhana, first jhana concentration, there are 34 mental formations. If a meditator cannot differentiate, this is consciousness, this is contact, this is feeling, this is perception, this is volition, etc., then we cannot say he or she understands mentality. What is Buddha's instruction? Especially in Mahasatipatthana Sutta, four foundations of mindfulness, correct? Four foundations of mindfulness of the Buddha says this system. Iti ijadava kaya kaya nubasi viharati, vahijava kaya kaya nubasi viharati, ijadava vahijava kaya kaya nubasi viharati. What is the meaning? Thus he abides desanay, adimad madirayati, and mentality. Internally. Thus, he abides discerning ultimate materiality and mentality externally. Thus, he abides descending ultimate materiality and mentality both internally and externally. There are two reasons. One reason is if you can descend ultimate materiality as well as ultimate mentality both internally and externally, at that time you can descend dependent origination. Another reason is to contemplate as anicca, dukkha, ananda, both internally and externally. Usually we have attachment not only to ourselves but also to external things. Is it true? You already understand.
Yeah.
So, the power of vipassana. If you can contemplate internal materiality and mentality as anicca, dukkha, and anatta, then attachment to internal body disappear temporarily. If you can contemplate both internally and externally as anicca, dukkha, anatta, at that time only your inside knowledge can destroy attachment to both internally and externally. If the vipassana insight can destroy the defilements temporarily, at that time only path and pushing knowledge can arrest at the end of mature insight knowledge. At that time only path knowledge can destroy defilements completely without remainder, stage by stage. So because of this reason, before descending dependent origination, first you must try to descend ultimate materiality and mentality, both internally and externally. If there is no light of vajra, eye consciousness cannot see. Eye consciousness also can see just color only, but mind, vajra, eye, in different ways, many ways they can see. Mind, vision, eye can see ultimate, this is ultimate materiality, this is ultimate mentality, this is nature, this is dukkha, this is anatta, etc. In different ways, many ways they can see. you want to practice Tibetan origination, to understand by your direct knowledge, first you must try to discern ultimate materiality and materiality, both internally and externally. If a meditator gets on this approximate path, past causes, then she should try to discern mentality and materiality, but up to the conception stage. For example, she should try to discern this morning mentality, materiality, yesterday mentality, materiality, day before yesterday mentality, materiality, etc. Then up to the inside mother's womb, up to the conception stage or path linking mind movement stage. After designing ultimate materiality and mentality in conception stage in this very life, then in meditation must continue to discern mentality and materiality in previous existence, especially near death moment. Usually in time of birth linking mind movement or conception stage, there are three types of materialities and the four types of mental formations. Three types of kalapas are body target kalapa, sat target kalapa, and heart target kalapa. In each kalapa, there are 10 types of materiality, such as earth element, water element, fire element, wind element, color, odor, flavor, nutritive present, life quality, and body transparency, or sex determining materiality, or heart target, heart base. After discerning this materiality and mentality, one should continue to discern ultimate materiality and mentality in previous life. According to Buddha's teaching, in previous life, last mind movement is called death consciousness mind movement. In this very life, first mind movement is called birth linking mind movement. Between these two mind movements, death consciousness mind movement and birth linking mind movement, there is no gap. No interval, no interval life. Immediately after death consciousness finished, the birth linking mind movement in this very life arise. In meditation, much trying to see these two types of mind movements, then he should try to see death proximate object in previous life. I would like to explain with one example. A lady, when she discerned that proximate object, she saw she is offering food to the Sangha. However, when offering food to the Sangha, she is not moving, she is bhikkhu. So, when she discerned one by one, four elements in each person, other mentality and material are not one line to his, to her mentality and materiality. But when she discerned one bhikkhu, offering bhikkhu, offering, that his mentality and materiality are one line up to this present moment. Then I suggest her to discern actually while offering for mentality and materiality. To discern mentality and materiality when she is really offering food to the Sangha. When offering food, she had no wish to become woman and future existence. But she had one type of inclination for this problem. When visiting two different pagodas, on the way, accidentally, he saw one lady, very beautiful and with long hair. That lady's hair is very thick and very long. She is very beautiful.
아름다운 여성이었어요.
And then that bhikkhu has the desire to be like that lady.
바로 그 뱅의 비구는 이 여성과 같이 되고 싶다라는 욕망이 생겼습니다.
This is problem.
그것이 문제였던 거죠.
Then one day he offered to the food to the Sangha. When offering food, he had such memory.
그 음식을 공양할 때 그 기억이 났던 것입니다.
So he had inclination to be such a beautiful man, thick and long-haired woman. One by moment,
decided. 한순간에 심찰나였습니다.
One by moment, decided to become man or to become woman. If he knows beautiful woman with long hair, such understanding is wrong understanding. This wrong understanding is called avijja, ignorance. Depending on this ignorance, she had attachment to that woman's heart. That attachment is called craving tanha. Then repeated attachment is called clinging upadana. These three are the development rounds, kilesa order. So depending on this development round, she accumulates wholesome karma. Which type of wholesome karma? Offering food to the Sangha. While offering food to the Sangha, there are 34 mental formations. These 34 mental formations are called Sankhara. But these Sankharas are also anicca and permanent. As long as they arise, they pass away very, very quickly. But they, when they pass away, perishing away, they left behind the karma potentiality, which can produce new existence. So altogether, there are five causes. Ignorance, craving, clinging, volitional formations, and karma potentiality. So karma already exists. It is not easy to destroy. If you want to destroy this karma, then you must try to be arhat. Only arhat but can destroy completely without remedy this karma potentiality. So altogether there are five causes already exist. Then these five causes become mature in time of death. Because of the mature to this karma potentiality, in time of death, this object appears again. This object means offering food to the Sangha, this object appears again. So, because of this karma potentiality, then if she trying to see causal relationship between cause and effect, then karma potentiality in this very life, 30 times of rupa materiality, in time of birth, again, mind, moment. So she tried to see both sides, karma potentiality, materiality, karma potentiality, materiality. Then this karma potentiality produces these 30 types of materiality she already see. So mind produces mind from materiality. In the same way, this karma also produces karma from materiality and then of birth, linking, my moment. After discerning this cause and effect, she cried a lot. We could become woman, father's
wife.
Is it okay? Good?
좋은 겁니까?
So one by moment is very important. While accumulating karma, if you cannot control your mind, this is problem. That lady in this very light, very thick and very long hair. Karma create this one. When she stand up, her hair is on the floor. Very long. Not your hair.
그녀는 이 생에서 정말 아름답고 산단같이 뚝뚝.
So karma is very wonderful. If you understand this divinity origination, by your direct knowledge, at that time only, you can become real bodies. Why? You cannot change. Because you understand karma. You understand karma produces karma. Materiality and mentality. At the day, you will not accept there is creator, there is no karma or there is no future existence, there is no past existence. Such type of wrong views will never rise to your mind. Buddha only teach there is cause, there is effect. But Buddha also teach because of the complete cessation of causes, aggregates also cease completely without reminder. That cessation is also called Nirodha Sitya, the cessation of suffering in the Thayana Sutta. Five causes we have already explained: ignorance, craving, clinging, formation, sankhara, original formations and karma potentiality by aggregates rise. This is causal rising. Then causal cessation means because of the complete cessation of these five causes, ignorance, craving, clinging, volition and formations and karma potentiality, the five aggregates cease completely without remainder. That complete cessation is because of Arahant path. Arahant path destroys all defilements, ignorance, craving and clinging. Because of the complete cessation of these causes, then five aggregates after final cessation no more exist. That complete cessation only. But here Buddha teaching is called Vipichavada. Vipichavada means because of this, this rise. Because of the cessation of this, this cease. In this way only. The destruction of the taste because is for those poor ones who knows and sees. It is not for one who does not know and does not see. This is Buddha's teaching in Sicca Sanyoga, Aswakriya Sutra. I only recite the Sutra in Pali. Is it okay?
괜찮습니까?
Jana doham bhikkhu vipassato asvanakhiya vadami no ajana do no abhasato. Kincha bhikkhu vichana do kipassato asvanakhiya hodi. Idan dukkhani bhikkhu vichana do passato asvanakhiya hodi. Ayan dukkha smudhiyo di chana do passato asvanakhiya hodi. Ayan dukkha niyodo di chana do passato asvanakhiya hodi. Ayan dukkha niyodo gamini vidibhita di chana do passato asvanakhiya hodi. Eum ko bhikkhu e chana do eum passato asvanakhiya hodi. Tasmadiya bhikkhave idam dukkhani yogam karaniyo ayam dukkha smudhiyo di yogam karaniyo ayam dukkha nirodho di yogam karaniyo ayam dukkha nirodha gamini paripada di yogam karaniyo.
ဒီနုမံကံပရိယကိုသိကြကြည်တော်ညွန်သိစွာဖြင့်တိုင်လျက်ကြည်ကြကိုယ်တော်သက်ပရိသာဘုံတော်ဘုံတော်ကရာဏီယောယေပပကံပတ္တိအခါကတိသူဒီမေယကုန်ခင်ချမ်းသာဉာဏ်ရှင်ဒီဟောသူမောကပ္ပတေဖြစ်ပါစေတည်းသဇနံတံဝိမံသာတို့ဤဉာဏ်ဒီဝတ္တနောသဇေကိုတုဝါဇေတောပြျာပြျာစွာသည်
ဘုရားမူလီဘောလီမီအမြဲတောအပရာဇိကမြာကိုပြညာတော်ပြင်ဖြစ်တဲ့ယံတော်ယံဓမ္မမဘောအမြဲတော်မူပြီးတကယ်တော်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်ဘုရားမြတ်
ဘုရားရှင်တို့ယင်ပရိနိယကုသဇာတိတဇောတိသာတေနယောလျာရှိကြကုန်သောသတ္တပရိသာပေါင်းသောကောင်းတို့သည်ရာဏျောညံပသက္ခမပြကခန္တိဥခိကုသဇာတိယေသန္တေရှိကြကုန်၏ဘုံတို့ဖြစ်ကြပါစေကုန်သတည်း